Hello everyone, welcome to Lukman IAS. Today we are going to have the Hindu analysis of 8th October 2020. So let us see which are the important articles in today's The Hindu newspaper. These are important articles for mains purpose and for prelims purpose. Let us see one by one these articles. First article on page number 6, editorial page 4-1. So the article, as the name suggests, is talking about the quadrilateral or quad grouping meeting, quad strategic dialogue meeting that has recently taken place in Tokyo, Japan. Now quad grouping basics हमने पहले भी देखा है कौन से चार countries है, like India, Japan, USA and Australia. These four countries specifically we can say placed across the Indo-Pacific region. ठीक है, Indo-Pacific यानी कि Indian Ocean और Pacific Ocean में, and also they are important democratic countries or democracy in these countries. So they have come together to have such kind of security dialogue. The origin can be traced in 2007 by the idea was given by PM of Japan, Shinzo Abe, at that time. Fine. Now the importance of Quad has increased when we talk about, let's say, increasing aggressive role of China in South China Sea, East China Sea, or we can say that the LAC tensions that are going between India and China in last 6 months, we can say that. So because of that, the importance of Quad grouping has increased. So yes, the meeting and the outcome, and let's say what analysis it is talking about, let us try to understand. Okay, so yes, Quad meeting in Tokyo, Japan, with the second meeting in 1 year, Australia, India, Japan, United States, quadrilateral security dialogue of foreign ministers in Tokyo on 6th October, the Quad has entered a decisive phase. तो इससे पहले इतना importance नहीं दिया जाता था Quad को, because we know that we did not want to, let's say, instigate or provoke China, as China considered this as, let's say, anti-China or mini NATO, ऐसे भी बोलता है China इसको, ठीक है, तो North Atlantic Treaty Organization जो है NATO, तो उसको मिनी NATO बोलते हैं एशिया पैसिफिक रीजन में. चाइना ऐसे बोलता है कि इट इज़ अगेंस्ट चाइनाज इंटरेस्ट. सो यस, इन अ डिपार्चर फ्रॉम द अर्लियर सीक्रेसी, दे मेड अ पब्लिक लार्जर पार्ट ऑफ देयर डिलिब्रेशंस, इंक्लूडिंग द डिसीजन टू मेक फॉरेन मिनिस्टर मीटिंग एट एज एन एनुअल इवेंट टू कोऑपरेट इन द कॉम्बैटिंग पैंडमिक ऑन बिल्डिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कनेक्टिविटी सप्लाई चेन इनिशिएटिव इन द रीजन. सो कनेक्टिविटी जो है 5G से रिलेटेड, इंडिया जापान के बीच में एक एग्रीमेंट हुआ है रिसेंटली, वो भी हम आज डिस्कस करेंगे. सो इन टोक्यो US सेक्रेटरी माइक पॉम्पे मेड इट क्लियर दैट हिज मिशन वॉज टू डायरेक्ट द क्वाड टूवर्ड्स बिल्डिंग ए कोएलिशन टू काउंटर बीजिंग्स एग्रेशन इन द रीजन. सो यस, वी कैन से दैट US चाइना ट्रेड वॉर्स आर ऑलरेडी गोइंग ऑन, द टेंशंस हैव escalated very, let's say, to high level. And yes, the US Secretary of State, he wants this Quad grouping to become a military alliance. ठीक है, जो बाकी countries ज़्यादा नहीं चाहती है, because we know that Japan, Australia and India are very much, we can say that, dependent on China. Also, they do not have that much capability to counter China. Let's say except USA in this grouping. What he seemed to propose was not just a coalition of democracies committed to a free and open Indo-Pacific, as Quad's informal charter has thus far stated. Instead, the US seems to keen on turning the quadrilateral into full-fledged military alliance. So, ये हम देखते हैं कि increasingly Quad का role military alliance होने के direction में चल रहा है. Led by USA. Now what the analysis is talking about in this article, the government should not downplay the import of such openly stated intentions. While Japan and Australia are bound by alliance treaties to the USA, New Delhi, yani ki India, has thus far charted its course on strategic autonomy. So India is the only country in that grouping which does not align with any grouping. ठीक है, तो ऑस्ट्रेलिया जापान का उनके साथ जो है अलायंस है यूएस के साथ, यूएस जो बोलेगा, यूएस ने अगर वॉर भी डिक्लेयर किया तो जापान तो ऑटोमेटिकली आ जाता है. ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज आल्सो अलाइड टू यूएसए इन सच मैटर्स. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन से दैट इंडिया इज ओनली कंट्री विच मेंटेन्स स्ट्रेटेजिक ऑटोनॉमी इन दिस ग्रुप. मिस्टर पॉम्पेस वर्ड कुड वेल बी ब्लस्टर बॉर्न ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स अहेड ऑफ यूएस इलेक्शंस. वी कैन से दैट ahead of US election, the president of USA is also continuously criticizing China. तो हम बोल सकते हैं कि वो political statement भी ज़्यादा politically motivated statement हो सकता है, right? So yes, but they point to an interest in bringing India into bilateral tensions in the Indo-Pacific. So basically, it is like dragging India in the bilateral tensions between USA and China. Fine. So India should be very cautious in that while taking any decision. In conclusion, we can say very good statement here. India has much to gain strategically and in terms of capacity building from quadrilateral dialogue, but little from impression it is being led by Washington on an important initiative for the region in which India is equal and important stakeholder. So we can say that in Indo-Pacific, India is one of the major stakeholder among these four countries, we can say that. And that's why its say or its decisions are very much important to this grouping, and it should maintain such kind of strategic autonomy while taking any decision, and it should not align with any such kind of grouping which is led by USA. So in conclusion, it is saying that. So such kind of question we can expect here. Despite of its significance, India should be more cautious while moving ahead with quadrilateral security dialogue. Analyze the statement. So some inputs from this article. Yes, the Quad meeting in Tokyo, the context can be given from this meeting, and yes, how USA is for, let's say, more and more pressurizing to make this coalition of democracies into a full-fledged military alliance. तो ये चीज आपको यहाँ पे बतानी पड़ेगी कि वी शुड बी वेरी कॉशियस इन दैट एस्पेक्ट एंड वी शुड मेंटेन स्ट्रेटेजिक ऑटोनॉमी एंड इन सिग्निफिकेंस पार्ट वी कैन से दैट यस स्पेशली एक्ट एज अ डिटरेंस फॉर चाइना और वी कैन से दैट इट एक्ट एज अ कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग स्पेशली फॉर इंडियन नेवी. ठीक है, तो इंडियन नेवी का कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग के लिए काफी इंपॉर्टेंट है. वी कैन से दैट बाय इंक्लूडिंग ऑस्ट्रेलिया इन द मालाबार एक्सरसाइजेस वी कैन फोकस ऑन कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग स्पेशली एंड इवन द डिटरेंस एस्पेक्ट. सो सिग्निफिकेंस में आप ये बोल सकते हैं एंड कॉशियस, यस, पॉलिटिकली मोटिवेटेड नहीं होना चाहिए एंड अलाइन नहीं होना चाहिए. ओके, फाइन, मूविंग ऑन टू नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल. Yes, somehow difficult to understand. This article is very much related to our ethics paper and essay paper, philosophical topics that can be asked in ethics. So yes, using facts to hide the underlying truths, as we know that Rajiv Bhargava writes very good articles related to your ethics paper, polity, social justice, and in general some important social issues that he keenly observes and do very much very good analysis of. So yes, using facts to hide the underlying truths. So what the article is talking about, the horrifying act or let's say incident of Hathras recently, the gang rape that happened and let's say atrocity involved, we can say that towards the lower caste people, and that too we can say gender violence. The combination of these two, the horrifying incident which again shook the let's say conscience of nation. So the article is saying that how the public discourse, especially led by the political parties, even including ruling parties, is let's say deceiving the people by using different kind of statements and hiding the truth. Okay, so this is what the article is completely talking about. So such kind of question we can expect with reference to cases of caste and gender related violence. Explain the importance of truth in ensuring social justice. So ethics mein aap aise question expect zarur kar sakte hai, importance of truth, and we can say that even we can give the reference of Gandhiji here. To not have feelings of anger, horror and outrage indicates an emotional and moral disability. Comment in the light of horrifying incidences of gang rapes and its impact on conscience of people. So yes, conscience of people, yes, ye jo incidences hote hain, and how people react to such kind of incidences, how their conscience, let's say, speaks about such incidences. This is what it is talking about, the anger, horror, outrage that should be, let's say, reflected, expressed And if we are not expressing, this reflects the emotional and moral disability. So, very good statement there from this article. Yes, let us try to take input from this article. What the article is talking about? Yes. So, in Hathras incident, people have witnessed not just the most brutal phase of social oppression, but a cynical and brazen use of state machinery to support the oppressor. So, here the main aspect of state to ensure the social justice, that is enshrined in the social contract, we can say that, that is missing. And yes, the brazen and cynical use of this state machinery to support the oppressor, this is we can say that very, let's say, worrying aspect here. Political parties, including ruling parties, shaping the discourse, public discourse around the incident by using false argument to deceive the listeners, that is common public. So what the argument that the article is talking about or giving here is like, this is no ordinary or fake news or misinformation, but the clever use of seemingly appropriate words and phrases with clear intention to deceive the populace. तो उन्होंने काफी अच्छे एग्जांपल दिए हैं कि कैसे डिसीव किया जा रहा है. लाइक सम पॉलिटिशियन और मिनिस्टर मे हैव गिवन दिस स्टेटमेंट लाइक आई वाज पेन्ड एट द डेथ ऑफ यंग वुमन. सो यस, ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट डेथ एंड नॉट मर्डर. सो हियर डेथ फेल्स टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन डिमाइज ऑफ पर्सन बाय नेचुरल कॉजेस, एक्सीडेंट, सुसाइड और मर्डर. सो दैट्स व्हाई द वर्ड, दो करेक्ट, हाउएवर we can say that, see here, appropriate words and phrases are being used, but the clear intention of deceiving the populace. Ab yahan pe murder ke badle death use kiya gaya hai, that means the impact of this statement or this word on the people is, we can say that, less as compared to murder. When we talk about murder, there is some kind of, let's say, atrocity being done, there is some kind of violence is let's say there. So that word is not used here. To speak of death of a person when she was murdered is grossly misleading. Likewise, the pain alone not an appropriate emotion in the face of brutal murder. To not have feeling of anger, horror, outrage indicates emotional and moral disability. This is what the statement we had used for the question. Also, very often explanations that are otherwise factually correct और ट्रू आर इक्वली डैमेजिंग. यानी कि कोई एक्सप्लेनेशन दे रहे हैं कि आप मतलब कोई इंसिडेंट कैसे हुआ, हाउ दिस इंसिडेंट हैपन्ड, एंड यू आर गिविंग द एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड दैट इज फैक्चुअली करेक्ट, हाउएवर दैट कैन बी ऑल्सो मिसलीडिंग और वी कैन से नॉट करेक्ट. हियर एग्जाम्पल गिवन लाइक एन इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफिसर एंटर्स ए चार्ड हाउस एंड फाइंड्स ए कैन ऑफ केरोसिन एंड यूज मैचस्टिक्स. As he exists, a reporter asks how the house was caught on fire. The officer answers, because of presence of oxygen at the location. अब ये तो कोई भी बता सकता है ना कि ऑक्सीजन की वजह से आग लगी होगी. Without oxygen, then there cannot be fire. So that is factually correct. However, this is not the correct answer. The answer is wrong because good explanation needs to be not merely factually correct but relevant to the question at hand. Right, so finding the motive and attributing responsibility for the criminal act is very much important. Fine, broadening the discussion in the immediate aftermath of atrocity by speaking generally about rapes all over the country deflects from the specific atrocity in Hathras and lets its perpetrator get off the hook. So basically, in general, people start talk about, let's say, rapes are happening all over country. ये जो generalize हम करते हैं, ठीक है, especially those who are there as a, let's say, responsible person in the state, like politicians or let's say police officers and civil servants, we can say that they should not give such kind of common statement. This deflects from the specific atrocity. Fine, horrendous as well. All rapes are, it was not just any woman who was brutalized by some men, but a Dalit who was sexually assaulted and killed by upper caste men. Indeed, she was reportedly gang raped and murderously beaten, not only because she was a Dalit, but precisely because इन द पास्ट हर फैमिली हैड रेजिस्टेड अपर कास्ट डोमिनेशन. ऐसा जरूर कुछ हुआ होगा तभी तो ऐसे हीनस क्राइम जो हम कास्ट डिस्क्रिमिनेशन या कास्ट सिस्टम में हम देखते हैं कि अभी भी स्टिल देर आर सच काइंड ऑफ इंसिडेंसेस दैट आर हैपनिंग. फाइन, दीज टू जनरलाइज स्टेटमेंट्स टेंड टू देन ऑब्लिटरेट द वेरी रीजन फॉर विच द सम पीपल आर किल्ड टू मिसट्रीट डिस्क्रिमिनेट एंड टारगेट इंडिविजुअल्स बिकॉज ऑफ देयर कलर जेंडर रिलीजन और नेशनलिटी इज टू कमिट ए क्राइम क्वालिटेटिवली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर हॉरिफिक एक्ट्स. यानी कि कहीं पे भी अगर कोई एक डेथ हो जाता है, सपोज बिकॉज ऑफ लेट्स से रोड एक्सीडेंट देर इज डेथ, एंड सपोज देर इज सम काइंड ऑफ लेट्स से जेंडर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन एंड असॉल्ट और सेक्सुअल असॉल्ट एंड देन वी कैन से डेथ, दैट इज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द डेथ हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ रोड एक्सीडेंट. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज क्वालिटेटिवली डिफरेंट, द क्राइम क्वालिटेटिवली डिफरेंट. फाइन, फॉर इट अटैक्स एंड टेररिजेस नॉट जस्ट वन पर्सन बट हर एंटायर कम्युनिटी. सो बी इट लेट्स से वीमेन और वी कैन से दैट लोअर कास्ट और पर्टिकुलर रिलीजन, हियर इट इज फोकसिंग ऑन लेट्स से कंप्लीट एंटायर कम्युनिटी. फाइन, इन केसेस सच एज हाथरस एट्रोसिटी वेयर कास्ट एंड जेंडर ऑपरेशन आर डीपली इंटरट्वाइंड वन कैनॉट बी लेट्स से फोरग्राउंड जेंडर इन अ वे दैट प्रिवेंट्स पीपल फ्रॉम सीइंग द कैजुअल रोल ऑफ कास्ट इन द वायलेंट आर्ट. सो टू प्लेस द एम्फेसिस ऑन जस्ट वन एंड नॉट ऑन द अदर इज ऑल्सो टू डिस्टॉर्ट द actual or true account. So basically here we should not be only focusing on let's say it is a case of gender violence or it is a case of caste conflict, rather than there is some kind of intertwining between these two factors and that should be focused here. Okay, so yes, the complete article is very much let's say doing critical analysis of this incident and we should take input from this article likewise. Yes, next, playing catch up in the flood forecast technology. Yes, the context of the article is that we need to let's say improve or modernize our flood forecasting technology, and the present technology that we have is inadequate, outdated, and therefore like the developed countries like USA, Japan has adopted the modern technology called as ensemble technology that should be adopted in India. Yes. So, कभी कभी यूपीएससी जो है यूपीएससी टेंड्स टू आस्क सम स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस एंड यस टू पॉइंट्स ऑफ आवर सिलेबस आर मिक्सिंग विथ ईच अदर. दिस इज नाउ द न्यू ट्रेंड इन मेंस. सो GS3 में सच काइंड ऑफ लेट्स से टू टॉपिक्स लाइक यूज और एप्लीकेशन ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी इन द डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट. सो हियर द फ्लड इज द डिजास्टर एंड द डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट यूज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी इन दैट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट. So that can be the question here, that and very good inputs can be taken from this article. So yes, let us try to take input. What the article is talking about? Yes, what are the stakeholders in the flood forecasting? Yes, Indian Meteorological Department (IMD) issues meteorological or weather forecast. This is the first. While the Central Water Commission, it issues flood forecast on various river points. This is the second stakeholder. The end user agencies are disaster management authorities, third stakeholder, and local administration, district administration jo hai, that is the fourth stakeholder. So we can say that these are the main stakeholders in that disaster management and let's say issuing of such kind of warning. Therefore, the advancement of flood forecasting depends on how quickly rainfall is estimated and forecast by IMD and how quickly CWC integrates that rainfall forecast, also known as qualitative precipitation forecast QPF, with the flood forecast. It is also linked to how fast the CWC disseminates this data to end user agencies. So these are some important aspects that we need to consider for flood disaster management. So, does the length of time from issuance of flood forecast and occurrence of flood event termed as lead time is the most crucial aspect of any flood forecast. Some technical words should be mentioned in your answer, such kind of lead time that we can say. And technology plays a part of, in the increasing this lead time. At present, we can say that the present technology only gives the 24-hour lead time to, let's say, make the district administration, local administration prepared for such kind of emergencies or let's say disaster. In India, outdated technologies, lack of technological parity between multiple agencies, and their poor water governance decreases crucial data lead time. Forecasting errors increases, and the burden of interpretation shifts to hapless end user agencies, yani ki disaster management authorities and local administration. The outcome is increase in flood risk and disaster. So what is the way forward? Ensemble technology. So here we know that the global weather phenomenon is chaotic. Any small change in a particular area, weather of particular area, or the climatic change, it has huge impact or severe impact on the weather and climate of another region located in very far away from that region. So therefore, beyond a lead time of 3 days, a deterministic forecast becomes less accurate. The developed world has shifted from deterministic forecast towards the ensemble weather models. Ye deterministic jo hai abhi present hai India mein. So that major uncertainty by causing perturbation in initial conditions, reflecting the different states of chaotic atmosphere, and the probabilities are then computed from different flood events with the lead time of beyond 10 days. Here we are getting the lead time beyond 10 days. In deterministic forecast, we can say that 24 hour to 3 days maximum. Although the IMD has begun testing and using ensemble models for weather forecasting through its 6.8 petaflop supercomputers, Pratyush and Mihir, the forecasting agency has still to go and catch up with advanced technology. Okay, it has to modernize not only telemetry infrastructure but also raise technology compatibility with river basin specific hydrological, hydrodynamic and inundation modeling. To meet that objective, it needs technologically capable workforce also. Fine. So with integration of between multiple flood forecasting agencies, end user agencies can receive the probability forecast that can give them ample time to decide, react, prepare and undertake risk-based analysis. ठीक है, तो ये conclusion में आप बोल सकते हो. So some specific analysis is required in such kind of questions. Moving on to next article. Yes, here we can say that the questions that can be asked: examine the need to modernize the flood forecasting technology in India. Discuss the issues in the flood forecasting technology in India. जो अभी है हम बोल सकते हैं जो outdated है, तो उसको आपको explain करना है. Suggest the measures to ensure. You can give the specific ensemble technology and we can mention some, let's say, extra additional points like need to have a technical expertise or manpower in this respect also. Yes, some important developments. Yesterday we suggested, जैसे हमने physics के लिए देखा था. Yes, now the Nobel Prize 2020 for chemistry is also announced, and it goes to a gene editing technique that is developed by Emmanuel Charpentier of France and Jennifer Doudna of USA. And this is for the first time the Nobel Science Prize has gone to women only team. So CRISPR-Cas9. तो ये टेक्नोलॉजी के बारे में हमने पहले भी पढ़ा है द हिंदू एनालिसिस में. एंड नाउ दिस टेक्नोलॉजी हैज, लेट्स से द डेवलपर ऑफ दिस टेक्नोलॉजी हैज गॉट नोबेल प्राइज इन केमिस्ट्री. ओके, सो यस, सो दीज आर टू वुमेन, जस्ट 6th एंड 7th वुमेन टू रिसीव नोबेल प्राइज इन केमिस्ट्री. कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स है, लाइक क्रिस्पर कैस नाइन टेक्नोलॉजी के बारे में जानते हैं. दिस टेक्नोलॉजी इज बेसिकली जीन एडिटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी दैट कैन बी यूज फॉर पर्पज ऑफ अल्टरिंग जेनेटिक एक्सप्रेशन और चेंजिंग जीनोम ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म. तो फुल फॉर्म क्या है? द क्लस्टर्ड रेगुलरली इंटरस्पेस्ड शॉर्ट पैलिंड्रोमिक रिपीट्स और क्रिस्पर एसोसिएटेड प्रोटीन कैस नाइन. क्रिस्पर कैस नाइन सिस्टम हैज रिवोल्यूशनाइज जेनेटिक मैनिपुलेशन. So what are the uses? Its many potential applications include correcting genetic defects, treating and preventing the spread of diseases and improving crops. So agriculture में भी हम बोल सकते हैं genetically modified crops, which are we can say that drought resilient or pest resistant crops होते हैं ना, तो वो the development of such varieties, such kind of technology is very much useful. However, there are some ethical concerns, like recently in 2018, I guess, Chinese researcher has claimed that he used CRISPR technology to produce the world's first gene-edited babies to make babies immune to infection HIV. ठीक है, so such kind of moral concerns are also very much important to be, let's say, taken into consideration while applying such kind of technology. So such in 2019 prelims examination already the question has been asked. So you can see here the UPSC is always ahead of one step ahead of what we are reading here. So Cas9 protein that is often mentioned in news is related to molecular scissors used in targeted gene editing. So this is the answer here. Directly we can say that molecular scissors jisko bolte hai for use for gene editing purpose. Fine, or we can expect such kind of question also here. Nobel Prize 2020 chemistry is awarded to scientists for gene editing technologies. Yes, it is the first time that the Nobel Science Prize has gone to women only team. This is also correct. Gene editing technique has applications in health sector as well as agriculture. तो ये भी पता होना चाहिए कि एग्रीकल्चर में भी उसका यूज है. सो दैट्स व्हाई द आंसर इज डी ऑल ऑफ देम. यस, इंडिया जापान फाइनलाइज टेक्स्ट फॉर पैक्ट ऑफ एआई 5G. सो हियर द टेक्नोलॉजी रिलेटेड एग्रीमेंट दैट द एग्रीमेंट हैज बीन साइबर सिक्योरिटी रिलेटेड एग्रीमेंट. नाउ द टेक्स्ट ऑफ दिस एग्रीमेंट इज फाइनलाइज, इट इज नॉट साइंड येट. Okay, so 5G network and artificial intelligence, the agreement promotes cooperation in capacity building, research and development, security and resilience, and we can say that infrastructure, 5G, internet of things, AI among the others. Fine, okay. So in the bilateral relationship development, you can mention that point. Pandemic could push 150 million into extreme poverty. Here the World Bank has given its report, biennial report, poverty and shared prosperity. तो कुछ reports हमें पता होने चाहिए international bodies के. The global extreme poverty is expected to rise for the first time in 20 years because of disruption caused by COVID-19. तो कितने होने वाले हैं? Some 9.1% to 9.4% of world population will be affected, and 82% of the total will be in MICs, middle income countries. Fine, so these facts can be used for poverty related. Let's say अगर SA आता है तो SA में use करना चाहिए. GS 2-3 में अगर question आता है तो उसके बारे में भी आप mention कर सकते हैं. Some important captions and quotations, जो ethics related article हमने देखा था. And yes, the integration between multiple flood forecasting agencies, जो हमने flood forecasting technology के बारे में जो article पढ़ा था. You can use such kind of statements, captions in your essay paper as well as mains related questions. So these were important articles. Try to take input for examination. For further information on editorial or discussion or ED classes, wherein in-depth analysis of mains related issues is done by Ansari sir and team, you can contact Lukman IS. Thank you.